In certain circumstances, chemotherapy might be appropriate to treat prostate cancer. Conventional chemotherapy has been tested for decades in the treatment of early stage and advanced stage prostate cancer. So far, we don't have any evidence that using chemotherapy earlier in the disease, meaning before the cancer has spread, will change anything in the patient outcomes, meaning they don't live longer. Therefore, the majority of the use of conventional chemotherapy in prostate cancer has been in the advanced setting when the cancer does not respond to hormone deprivation anymore. This so-called castration-resistant state was very difficult to treat until about 2004. As a matter of fact, the only FDA-approved chemotherapeutic drug until then was mitoxantrone, which did not prolong the patient's life but improved the pain level of the patient, and that's how it was approved. In 2004, we had two large randomized trials showing us an effect on overall survival with a drug called docetaxel, which improved by about 3 to 4 months the survival of the patients. So this was our main treatment for patients with advanced prostate cancer over the past decade. More recently, a second drug called cabazitaxel, which is related to docetaxel, was approved for patients whose cancer does not respond to docetaxel anymore. Again, in this setting, patients who received cabazitaxel lived longer than those who received placebo. Now, we have more and more drugs coming in that are not traditionally regarded as chemotherapeutic drugs. There are more biologic drugs that affect testosterone signaling in the prostate cancer cells and are highly effective. So in 2013, we tend to use chemotherapy drugs later and later in the disease course, given the better tolerability of the newer drugs.
Some prostate cancers are high risk, aggressive, and more likely to spread. Others are low risk, least likely to have bad outcomes. The biopsy says cancer, but current diagnostic tools provide limited information about how aggressive a man's individual disease is. So most men decide to treat prostate cancer immediately. Once treated, many men experience serious long-term side effects, like incontinence and sexual impotence. Immediate treatment isn't always needed. But right now, a man can't be sure if his cancer is the kind that is likely to require treatment or if he's okay to wait for now. What if there was a test that could determine how aggressive prostate cancer is? Genomic Health is developing a new test to do just that. By reviewing the underlying biology of the tumor and using genes from multiple biologic pathways, the test can predict the aggressiveness of prostate cancer when diagnosed, allowing a man to make a more informed treatment decision with confidence, taking care of himself with more information and greater peace of mind.